What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today's reaction video is the most popular styles of homes in America. So this is a little bit different.
Yeah, a little bit to what we've done.
Hopefully it'll be multiple different homes, kind of, you get an idea, instead of like just the fanciest home, and you're looking around the fanciest one, an idea with what potentially normal people living, I say normal, people like
working
us.
Working class, yeah.
Yeah, just can't afford the biggest house in the world. Like, because some of the videos we've seen, being rich people, and their houses have been amazing.
Yeah.
I'm sure these houses are amazing as well, but it just gives a bit of a different idea, doesn't it?
I think so. I think it's a good one to do after, like, the last few home tours we've done.
Definitely.
Everyone's kind of said, you know, that's, don't generalise us, that's not what we all live in.
Well, but it is funny because it's a mix, because some people say most people don't live in that, and some people say most people do. So this is hopefully going to give us a different idea.
Yeah.
Smash the like button, guys. Smash the subscribe button. Are you ready?
I am.
Let's go. Most popular home styles in America. What we got?
No matter where you live, I'm sure you've encountered a wide variety of architectural homes just by driving around in different neighborhoods. Some of those might be extravagant, while others might
be
quaint. Homes across the United States have their own characteristics and beauty, just like the people who inhabit them. In this video, we will have a quick look at some of the most popular styles of homes in the U.S.
Yeah, they're all completely different, aren't they? Like, such a big difference.
Ranch-style homes date back to 1932, but they grew in popularity during the 1950s and 1960s.
Okay.
Today, they remain just as popular as ever. This iconic ranch architecture is known for its simple single-story floor plan that is low to the ground and usually has an open floor plan with an occasional basement. These homes typically have a smaller yard, attached garage, and a low-pitched roof. They also feature large windows and sliding doors that encourage indoor-outdoor living styles. Depending on which region of the country you live in, they may also be referred to as rambler homes.
They're nice.
The craftsman-style home became increasingly popular in the 1900s by architect and furniture...
The ranch-style homes?
Yeah.
We saw loads in Texas.
Yeah, we did.
Loads of them in Texas.
Yeah. I would say this is what we would classify an American home. So American. Like, that to me would be...
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Similar to what I would be thinking.
Yeah, this style, not ranch.
No, this.
Yeah, this style, because it threw me off in Texas that there were so many kind of ranch style. I knew there were some, but it was everywhere. You guys have explained to us why. I didn't think about the basement in the ranch style.
So no, I
didn't.
That
makes it bigger.
Mm.
Like, because, don't get me wrong, they were big anyway, but I was like, oh, you're just lacking multiple stories, so you do lack space.
But
well, you could have, but...
Underneath.
Basement is just a story underground. It makes sense.
Your designer, Gustav Stickley. It has remained popular throughout the 21st century. These homes have become a staple in American architecture with its exterior features including shingles, low-pitched roofs, and covered front porches. Craftsman homes also feature recognizable interior details such as thick trim, prominent ceiling beams, and built-in shelving and seating. They are highly desirable across the U.S. Ooh. Colonial-style homes have an East Coast architecture that has maintained its allure.
Which
in...
I guess is why...
Yeah, it gives me Abraham Lincoln vibes.
Yeah, I guess. I'm saying it looks British because it's brick. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it said...
Colonial.
Yeah, so it literally was when, obviously, the British was open and stuff like that a long time ago. Makes sense that it's brick.
Yeah. Just ours aren't that big.
Yeah, ours aren't that big. It's just the brick vibe, which you guys don't have as much brick.
In many parts of the United States since 1876.
That's nice.
These classic houses are known for their old-world charm, decorative doorways, and symmetrical window placement. Many colonial-style homes will have two or three stories, fireplaces, and brick or wood exteriors. Colonial-style homes are very prominent in the northeastern part of the United States. Cape Cod homes have roots that date back to 1675. They are charming and quaint homes that are reminiscent of the classic American cottage style. This type of home design migrated from England to the United States, maintaining its symmetrical design and central chimney. Cape Cod style homes feature a steep roof to keep the snow from accumulating, dormer windows for added light, wood siding and shutters to keep the heat in, and hardwood floors for comfort and practicality. These homes are very common in the New England region of the United States. Tudor-style homes originated in the 15th century during the reign of the House of Tudor. It is fairly easy to identify with its unique features. Typically,
I mean, you may
we went down Castle Heights in LA. And they were like so many Tudor homes.
Yeah, but if you, I was going to say how many Tudor homes is there actually in the US? Obviously, Victorian, we saw the Painted Ladies.
Yes.
Which is a bit more Victorian era and stuff like that. So there definitely is, like you say, we've seen some Tudor ones. I think I even said to you, I said, I think it was near the Beverly Hillside.
It was Castle Heights.
It was like, is that what
yeah,
that
because
is?
I really like the area, so I looked at homes.
I think on a video, I said, oh, there's a Tudor home over there. I didn't expect that, because the Tudor style, at least.
Yeah, it was on that, like, just that road.
Yeah, if you're looking
so
at
many.
The sign, it was like on the left, wasn't it? Like, if you're heading towards the sign on your right.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, I think I did it on video, which will be in a vlog eventually, and I was quite surprised to see that. So, how many actually is there? Let us know in the comments.
They have a combination of brick, stone, or stucco exterior and a decorative half-timbering on the second story to create the well-known striped exterior. They also feature a steeply pitched roof, cross gables, and tall, narrow windows. Today, Tudor-style homes are prominent in the Northeast and Midwest regions of the United States. Small log cabins have been built for several hundred years, with European settlers bringing the style to North America. This primitive style of building originally consisted of modest one-room homes in the wilderness. Today, people build modern cabins as their primary residence in rural and suburban settings for the aesthetic.
So nice. Imagine
the exterior is often featured with logs or at least clad with wood in a nod to the original style. The shape is usually simple with a fairly open interior. Greek Revival architecture is inspired by buildings from Greece. This style first arrived in Britain during the 1700s, but it really didn't catch on in the United States until the 19th century.
Jeez.
As a new democracy, Americans wanted to pay tribute to the birthplace of democracy through architecture, which is why many governments...
But them columns at the front, just even if it was like a small house behind, the columns at the front, just to me, screams expensive.
Yeah, it does.
It just looks expensive. I imagine it is expensive because some columns, if they are the real deal, probably cost an absolute fortune as well.
Yeah.
But it looks so expensive.
Government buildings use this style. Home examples can be found across the U.S. The style is defined by large columns, a symmetrical shape, and a white facade. French country homes draw inspiration from centuries-old homes in the French countryside. These homes featured more natural and lived-in elements than the ornate French architecture that dominated the cities. Some key features of the French country homes include natural stone facades, a sloping roof, two chimneys, and a natural wood or stone flooring. French country homes can be found scattered in residential communities across the U.S.
Okay.
Victorian-style homes first appeared during the Victorian era from around...
It was on my way to the Painted Ladies.
There was quite
corner,
a few, wasn't there? Yeah.
I don't think we've had a little dome on top, though.
There was a few fancy ones.
Was there? Yeah. Didn't we want there were some fancy ones and they were stunning, but I didn't notice the dome.
Yeah,
that's incredible, isn't it? Wow, look at that.
1860 to 1900. They can be best described as colorful dollhouses with romantic and distinctive features. These houses have elaborate detailing in just about every part of the home, from intricate wood trim, ornate staircases, stained glass, and decorative woodwork.
You know, the TV series.
And it's just great architecture, isn't it? It is stunning architecture.
Victorian homes have steep gabled roofs, a front-facing gable, patterned shingles, bay windows, and a round tower and a front porch. Mediterranean-style homes are suitable for warmer climates, which is why they became so prevalent in Southern California during the 1920s and 1930s. They are influenced by architectural details taken from countries throughout the Mediterranean region. These homes typically have low-pitched red tile roofs, vaulted ceilings, arched doors and windows, and a stucco or adobe exterior. The floor plans are typically U-shaped, which creates a central courtyard for a garden or fountain. Today, this style of home has remained popular in California and Florida, but it can be found in other places as well. Modern-style homes emerged in the 1920s and embraced minimalism while rejecting the more ornate home styles.
And the thing is, you like a modern home, don't you?
Yeah, no, I don't like that.
Yeah, I wouldn't think it's fine. You know what I prefer is like some of the older styles we've seen, because some of them look absolutely stunning. And then maybe a bit more modern interior.
Yeah.
So from the outside, it's quite traditional. I prefer the look of a traditional.
Yeah, I'd prefer modern inside design. Like, I don't like that.
Yeah, I think to the core, modern or something like that. Modern and traditional.
What you're saying.
Do you know what I mean? Combine.
I think you've made that up.
Yeah, I might have. No, I've heard it before, but I think a person we've chatted about as a joke has said we're doing them flats, we're doing a modditional flat. Modern, traditional kind of mix.
I like
homes typically include progressive elements such as asymmetrical exteriors, flat roofs, and integrated outdoor spaces.
Oh my gosh.
Many modern interiors feature minimal molding and trim, neutral color palettes, and metal accents. A wide range of recently built homes are built with
standard American house to us.
That definitely seems more American.
That is literally, if you say to anyone,
It's like an American TV show.
I want an American house. That is what they're saying because that's what you see in the movies.
It's like a TV show.
Literally,
Contemporary style architecture. These homes have inventive designs and simple forms without elaborate ornamentation or detail. They usually have geometric lines, large windows and doors to bring in light, and open floor plans. They typically incorporate sustainable or eco-friendly building materials, textures, and components, exposed roof beams, and flat or low-pitched roofs. Cottage-style homes are inspired by the medieval styles of the English countryside. American architects designed the cozy cottage-style homes during the 1920s and 30s. These homes usually have steep thatch roofs, arched doorways, shuttered windows, and a warm storybook character bringing to life an old-world charm.
That's nice.
It is.
The farmhouse was designed back in the early 1700s, and it was built as housing for farmers who were all about practicality. Modern farmhouses still...
That's like a more typical expensive American house, I reckon, you know, with a little porch in there as well.
Wraparound porch, isn't it?
Yeah.
Exhibit many of the same features that the original design included, like large wraparound front porches, clapboard siding, large fireplaces, wood floors, eat-in kitchens, and oversized kitchen sinks. Mid-century modern style homes are part of the modernism movement that date back to post-World War II. These homes remain popular throughout the 1970s. Mid-century modern design is characterized by minimal...
That was like 2000s at least, you know. I want to put like 70s and 80s and stuff like combined with what we've seen on the screen, but obviously let us know in the comments if you know more about it.
Clean lines and floor-to-ceiling windows. You will often see open layouts and a mix of natural and manufactured materials for the interior elements like wood, stone, steel, and plastic. Townhomes originated in Europe and eventually they migrated to the United States where they are most commonly found in cities.
Townhomes have
spacious layouts and they offer more amenities than condo styles while being lower maintenance than most residential homes. These houses are typically two or three stories, share one or two walls with adjacent properties, and have a rooftop deck to enjoy sprawling views.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Another name for this type of housing is called row homes. Antebellum architecture or Southern architecture arose prior to the Civil War in the Southern United States. The design was intended to be both impressive and practical. The homes featured large windows and high ceilings, which looked dramatic and allowed for better air circulation.
That doesn't look like someone's house.
That doesn't look dramatic.
I know it's not a capital building, but that's like the architecture of a capital building. Like, that ain't someone's house. Like, surely not.
They also had large covered wraparound porches to enjoy the outdoors while being sheltered from the hot sun. These homes also had trademark features like winding staircases and columns. This style is still most common in the South, and modern versions still feature vaulted ceilings and large porches. There are certainly a wide range of styles when it comes to homes.
Definitely.
Whether you're in the market for a new home, or you just love to browse homes on your favorite real estate app, you're bound to find one that you fall in love with. I hope you enjoyed this little look into...
That was good. Yeah, you do it all the time, don't you?
Yeah, I literally...
Look at this house this much.
Literally, we were in America and I was literally just Googling.
And I was like, yeah, we have no money. Move on.
Yeah, but it's so nice.
Some very nice ones in there. I don't think we'll ever be able to afford most of them on there. Like, probably 99% of them.
No.
Maybe an old cottage. A rundown cottage.
Yeah, but then we'd have to spend so much money to make it livable.
Yeah, smash that button if you enjoyed, guys. Smash the subscribe button. A little bit different to what we thought. It wasn't quite, like, it was expensive homes, I believe. Again, let us know in the comments if that is typical or not. I'm assuming this is the upper class.
Yeah, I'm thinking so too.
But there were some stunning, stunning homes.
There was.
And there was, obviously. You can apply the architecture we've seen in the different types to smaller homes to get the drift.
Yeah.
Smash that button, guys. Smash subscribe and watch your video.
Have a fantastic day.
And we'll see you later in the next one. Peace. Do you want to leave it?
Yeah, he's been kicking off.